العلاج والمدارس حاليا متوفر داخل المخيم.
Schooling and healthcare are available inside the camps, and it's not bad to be honest, but we have bigger problems with long-term illnesses like cancer and meningitis. Even paralysis among children, which largely disappeared from the world decades ago, has come back. As an outreach volunteer, people approach me every day saying, look, I have cancer and I need blood transfusion, or those who have kidney problems and need a specific procedure. The procedures are not offered at the camp, nor are they capable of paying for them. I know a lot of people who needed a few simple procedures, but because of a lack of funds and the authorities' inability to pay, unfortunately they passed away.
I'm single. My whole family is not in the camp. They're not in Jordan. But for me as a single guy, all I think now is build up a new life. I want to go to college. I want to study. I want to have a decent life that I can't do now, that I can't have now. Not here in the camp, not back in Syria. All I'm trying to do now is get an opportunity to go somewhere and start a new life. But on the other hand, if we're talking about families, like if I was a married guy and I have a family, and you know, the Arabic culture is much different from the Western one, I would be just looking for a job and staying in the camp, or I might be thinking for leaving Jordan and going to another place to like resettle and build a new life. All I will be thinking of is just to start over. When I first came, I thought that I'm gonna be back to Syria in 3 or 4 months at the most. Mm. And I was just eating every day, drinking every day, just for the day I would get back. But now I'm looking for the day to leave from here and start a new life. I'm not thinking about Syria anymore because it's complicated.
Yeah.
It's more complicated than I thought.